In the previous video, I finalized and assembled my wire and gantry plates. I'm now going to make the PTFE anti-backlash nut blocks which will attach to them. As I'm building a lead screw machine, I will need a block with the same thread as the lead screw to attach to all the moving plates. There will be two for the Y axis, one for the X and one for the Z.
The individual pieces would have cost about 40 quid altogether to buy. This piece cost £15 and I should be able to make 8 out of it if I'm careful.
This is the nut block that I will be recreating, so I'm not going to design one from scratch. It is an open source design and I found the open builds diagram which I then used to recreate the lines as vectors in ArtCam. There is a version available to buy which is made from Delrin, like the wheels, but I'll be using PTFE or what is sometimes referred to as Teflon. This material is manufactured by the same company who produces the material for the wheels and it has the properties of very low friction and resistance to high temperature and chemicals which makes it perfect for the task. I then exported the vectors as an SVG file to Easel. I'm going to cut the nut trap and holes out first before screwing the block down to the wasteboard and cutting the outline. This way I can avoid using tabs, reduce scrap and cut up to 8 lead screw nut blocks from this single piece of 10x15cm 12mm PTFE. Let's see if the locking nuts fit, and they do. This is probably the nicest material you could ever machine, just because of how little friction it has on the bit. Seeing the success of the first nut block, I decided to cut the other three out.
I'm just going to check how these came out. This is the original one. So 32.5, 32.46.
I now need to secure them to the plates and drill and tap the holes in the correct position. The original design had a recess on the underside for some aluminium spacers, but I have not milled those out nor bought the spacers. I think I can alternatively use several wider washers to roughly position the nut block so it is in line with the center of the bearing hole. To do this, I'm going to place the Y plate onto a piece of C-beam and attach the end cap with its bearing in place. Just by looking through the bearing hole, I can tell I need more washers.
These are 2mm washers and the ones I've already added on here are 1mm, so that will create a 3mm spacing now.
I have these transfer punches, which I can square through the bearing using two small engineer squares, and tapping the transfer punch marks the PTFE. I had to do this a couple times before finding the position that seemed correct.
I just flipped this the other way around so I've got another clean surface to mark on. This is just a bit too close to where punch went and it's pulling it into the original mark. But I have worked out that from the edge of the C-beam my mark should be 32.4 millimeters in. So I will be able to take some measurements and then work out exactly where it should be using the vernier caliper.
While drilling the holes, I made sure to clamp some stop blocks to the table to allow me to repeat the positioning with the other nut blocks. I now need to make my own tap for the lead screw, which is a TR8x8x2. That is an 8mm trapezoidal lead screw with a lead of 8 and a pitch of 2. The lead being how far the nut block will travel with one full rotation of the lead screw. I bought a tap which had a lead of 2 that I mistook for the pitch. Thankfully it was quite cheap, but I couldn't find the correct tap and decided to make my own. I did this by cutting a small piece of lead screw around 70mm and turning it on the lathe while grinding a slight taper on one end. You could do this on the pillar drill with a file, providing you don't over apply force and possibly mess up the drill's bearings. Remember, if you use excessive force something will go wrong. I set the lathe fence to guide a small multi-tool with a metal cutting disc, so I could make two narrow lines on either side of the threaded rod. I then ground those lines with a larger disc, trying to carefully keep what will be the cutting teeth of the tap sharp. So with the taper facing towards me, that meant slightly tilting the grinding disc to the right. I then used a file to clean up some of the burr, and also ground a square end to fit the tap onto a handle. The tap worked pretty well, although the teeth did tear the PTFE a little. Considering I've just made this by hand, and more importantly the movement on the lead screw is really smooth, I'm happy to drill and tap the remaining blocks. I also drilled and tapped a hole for the tensioning grub screw, and then assembled a tester C-beam to check if everything lined up. And lo and behold, the bearing holes and the anti-backlash nut block all line up. So in the next video I'm going to make some locking collars and assemble the X and Y axis of the machine. If you like this video, do sacrifice a thumb and thanks again for watching. You can also support this channel by becoming a patron and sponsoring future videos. The link to that and the other usual things will be on screen now.